visitors. They've got Knox, and it's House in at the two spot.
Some talent for sure in the backcourt tonight, Greg. Did it ever add anything for you playing across from another top-level guard?
No, it always raises the stakes, and you want to rise to that challenge. But in the end, it all comes back to winning as a team.
Now, here's Fox. There's the pass to Quinn. Inside. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
An efficient start here offensively, working it inside for the easy two.
House dishes to Carter. Got a piece of it. Six to shoot. To the middle. Here's Knox, and he converts the layup.
Just setting the tone with an aggressive move to the rack. And where's the help defensively?
Yeah, APB sent out to try to find out where the defense is. Inexcusable.
Defended by Carter. Passes it to Blue. Second shot opportunity. Count that one.
Just a grinder. Always doing the dirty work on the offensive glass. And that's one of the things he brings to the table.
Into the lane. And he makes no mistake on the slam dunk.
And credit the screen for giving him the space he needed to get to the rim.
For sure, GA allows him to come in with the sledgehammer.
Yeah, well, he settled for the layup when you can attack the rim and rise up like that.
Now, here's Fox. We saw him with 10 points last game. Fires the three. Knight grabs the board. Gotten their first three shots to go in for him to start off this game. Carter, the pass to Knight. Back to Carter. In the tray. He's got five.
Boy, he is looking confident. Love how they're using him so far.
Yeah, right now I don't see any let up. Think he's going to just keep putting his foot on that gas pedal tonight.
Here's Quinn. And right away, they enjoy the three-pointer of their own.
And I like the back and forth here, showing confidence from Rain.
Well, it seems like they're going to find out who can make the deepest threes. Right now it's a shootout.
Here's Knox. Down low, off the mark, his first miss of the game, 1 for 2. In his first game after starting in the 2020 All-Star game, Trae Young had an incredible night, dropping 50 points against the Miami Heat.
And Young became the fourth youngest NBA player to get to 50. Only Devin Booker, LeBron, and Brandon Jennings got to 50 in the game at a younger age. Perhaps the most impressive part of Trae's performance, he did it against Coach Eric Spoelstra's Miami Heat, one of the top defensive teams in the league.
Here is House. His last outing, he had 8 points. They recovered. A nice shot by Knight. Here's Quinn. You saw him with 29 points last game.
2 minutes remaining in the first. 2 minutes.
Pass to Carter. Played in with a nice touch off the glass.
And their offense already in a flow. Some stellar shooting to jump out to this lead.
Now, here's Fox. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. To the paint. Here's Knight. And Knight slams it in.
And just tacks a few more points onto their lead with the tomahawk.
Ah, that's bringing it down hard. Pass to Blue. Now, here's Fox. Got a lot of room. Off the mark with the little step back, Johnny. Kicks it to Carter. The pass to House.
chance there to push it to double digits, but it's off the mark. Here's Blue, and you can see his scoring totals. Those are some pretty good numbers. He's putting up close to 15 points a game on average.
Yeah, another nice bucket down low. They've really been able to work the ball into the post effectively here so far.
House dishes to Carter. He takes it in. Here is House, guarded by Fox. Shot clock at 6. From deep. That shot off. Gone 4 for 9 from the field to start this game. 2 second difference between shot clock and game clock. Here's Quinn. His numbers are looking pretty good. He's got his scoring average up around 18.5 points a game. Shot is good. He's got 8.
He didn't need to fade back. No one in his face, but he buried it anyway.
And so the first quarter is in the books. Leading by 4. Stay with us as we get set to bring you the second quarter right after this. And hope you've enjoyed the broadcast so far, halfway through the first half in this one. And looking at what we've seen so far, guys, from the visiting team, what do you think?
Hey, why take jump shots when you can get your points at the rim?
Yeah, that worked wonders for them in the quarter. We'll see what kind of adjustments get made.
It's good.
And say what you will about the value of the three-pointer, but those close-in looks are always plan A. Every trip down, get to the paint, get deep, score.
And a chance here presented by Gatorade to see who's on the floor, all fueled up and ready to go for the start of the second quarter. Carter out there with Boss. Then there's Maker, and it's Crawford at the three spot. Driving the lane, and he goes in for the dunk.
Now that's some hang time. What a pretty double clutch move.
Agree, Greg. You can afford to get fancy on your way up when you've got that kind of space. Now here is Carter. Picked away. And they're on the break. No one near Williamson as he lets it go. Good on the three-point shot. Williamson's got himself going there. His first points of the game in the deep ball. Pass to Maker. Carter inside the three-point line. That one's off. Still out of sync.
Very dangerous to leave a guy like that open. Lucky break there for the D.
Driving inside. And he drops in the layup off the glass.
And the lead should be safe if they can keep shooting the basketball like this.
Timeout, timeout.
Let me remind the audience, Brett Berry, partner of 2 titles with the Spurs. Brett, what's the secret sauce to winning a title?
Yeah, honestly, you got to have a superstar. And I was lucky enough to play with the great Hall of Famer Tim Duncan, along with Greg Popovich. You got to have a couple of those guys on your team in order to win a title.
And here in the second, with about 1.5 minutes gone by, Crawford outside. And it comes off the front of the rim. One-on-one fast break. Down it goes for his 3rd basket in as many tries.
This offense just continues to impress.
Gone 0-3 and are still looking for that first bucket here in the second quarter. Quarter number 2, we're about 2 minutes in. Here's the break. Crawford with the rebound.
There's a little bit of pressure on him, but not enough to cause him to miss a shot that's in that close.
All the energy is on the other side right now, and every miss just makes it worse.
Away the other team is scorching hot, and they come down on this end. Can't find a way to get the embers going.
He gets right to the rim, but the defense there.
At the line,
the
Miller home team taking 2 shots.
And the first one drops. So after making the first, he goes 1 for 2. shooting at 44%, pretty reasonable. Carter, the best to make it. He kicks it to Crawford. Carter outside, lock at six, hits it from three-point range. Carter's got his first 3 points of the game.
You know, maybe he's not one of the elite sharpshooters, but even still, that's not a shot that D can afford to give him.
To the inside. Oh, yes, he did. Yes. 5 up and 5 down for him so far.
Yeah, they're going to have a nice little run here.
Pass to George. Outside Knight. He feeds it to Crawford. Outside, George. Crawford passes to Cook. Outside, George. That one falls, coming off Carter's feet.
Such a critical part of how their offense is going to flow. Things are only working when he seems to be on the floor.
Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. And he buries that one, drilling the rim on the way down. Carter's got his first basket. Gone 2 of 6 in the field in the second quarter so far. And here's Carter. He's a good contributor to his team, averaging about 10.5 points a game. That shot is no good, and he's 1 for 3 from the floor. Gotten nearly everything to fall for them here in the second quarter. They're a great 7 of 8 from the floor.
2 minutes remaining in the first half.
Defended by Carter. Inside. It's stolen by Maker. And stolen by Williamson. And there's a 1:45 left to play in the first half. Makes it off the glass. Williamson's got his second bucket tonight.
Just a much smaller defender on him. He does the exact thing at the right moment. Goes straight to the rim.
Here's Carter. And he makes good on the layup. Carter's got 5 points so far.
Yeah, there it is again. On a lot of their possessions this first half, they've established great inside position.
He's guarded by Knight. Some solid defense from Knight.
That is some tough defense there against one of the better finishers in our game.
Pass to Carter. The high post shot. No good there. Gone 8 of 10 from the field here in the second quarter. You've got to like how they've shot the ball. And Lakers sends it back. And so home team goes. And they retain possession. And now another look at that Mobile One block defensive performance.
Checking in for the away team.
That block could really help change the momentum of this game.
So both teams changing it up here. ...43 seconds left in the first half. All alone. Good as a two-shot fall. He's got 12.
This looks like he's got more feel tonight. Like he's really got a good grip on that ball as he's letting it go.
Carter outside. Here's Knight. Oh, and he knocks it off the glass. Wow. They get it back.
Away team foul. First personal foul.
Go the other way.
First team foul. Checking in for the away team.
Let's see if they can extend their lead to double digits.
And no reason to think they can't the way they're going.
The shot by Quinn, no good. Carter outside.
Resourceful move there, ending the period on a high note.
Great way to end the quarter there. Team is pumped up.
And so we wrap up the first half.
Thanks, Kevin. Trey, you've made it look easy so far. How have you been?
Thank you, David. And we'll be back after halftime as the third quarter gets underway.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello, basketball fans. Taking a look at this home squad.
Kenny, what was your impression?
They run this offense seamlessly. Each guy seems to understand his role. They're making smart decisions with the basketball, and I can give a shout out to the playmaker. This team's success is because of you, brother.
Check. And that should do it. With the second half about to begin, let's send you back to Kevin Harlan. Go back to Kevin Harlan. Go. Go over there.
And in that first half, we saw a pretty tight bend. We'll soon find out what sort of adjustments were discussed during the half. And the pass to Quinn. Here's Blue. To the paint. And he slams it one-handed.
Breaking out the Statue of Liberty on that dunk.
A nice way to pad that lead a little more. You're right. They've got Carter, and it's Knight in at the five down low. Carter, the pass to Knox. Beyond the arc. Nailed from three-point land. 8 points for him.
And kind of like playing in the rec league, little to no defense on that possession, and the easiest three-pointer you can imagine.
Knight grabs the ball. At 46%, making some buckets. Carter outside. That one falls. Carter's got 6 points.
That's the kind of aggressive and assertive play they need as we get closer and closer to crunch time.
Passes it to Blue. To the middle. Nice pass. Right over the rack, perfectly for the layup.
And that's exactly what you want to start the second half. Smart play call.
Halftime talks can go all over the board, but right there coming out, that's the way you want to start the half. Be aggressive.
Out to the right wing. Down low. Out to Carter. Six on the shot clock. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two.
Here's a personal foul. First team foul.
Free throw line for him in this one.
Shooting for the away team.
That's good from Carter.
Taking two shots.
Them both.
At this point, you might as well go ahead and chalk up the points when he's at the free throw line. Pretty much automatic.
Pass to Blue. Now Fox. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. And he drives in. Shot clock at five. Fades. And good as it just snuffs right down through the net.
And he should thank the team for those 2 points. Nobody paid much attention to him on that play.
Pass to Knox. Carter up top. Shoots from the high post. Buries the jump shot. From. Carter's got 6 points in the quarter.
Well, the talk at halftime must have been a good one. Right now, three straight buckets to start the quarter.
Guarded by Knight. It's stolen by Carter. And here comes House, leading the fast break. 2 points. That one goes.
And still perfect in the second half. Four straight makes.
Gone 3 of 5 to start the second half, developing a nice rhythm out there. Defended by Carter.
Away team foul. First personal foul. First team foul. Checking in for the away team.
Take another look at the staunch defense during that mobile one block.
And in a close game, blocks like that are so clutch, and that could be a real difference maker here tonight.
Second half of play, and we're 3 minutes into the third here. Fox again tonight, and Fox gets it to go.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Outside, George. It's George on the wing. And he banks in the lane. George has got five.
And they've had assists now in their last three baskets.
Fox looking it over. Knocks it loose. Good for his ninth make in just 12 shots. That's an even 75% shooting.
So far, he's a can't-miss player. A superb scorer who plays to his strength.
2 minutes remaining in the third. 2 minutes.
Kicks to Carter for the tie. He's off on that one. Round 5 of 7 from the field in the third quarter. Let's see if they can keep it up. Here's Blue. Good. And assist to Fox. Blue's got 4 this quarter.
Now that's the kind of passing right there that makes a difference, not just in that possession, but maybe on your play for the entire game.
Drills it from outside.
And that field goal percentage climbing now above 50%. They look like a different team here in the second half.
Now, here's Fox. Some good scoring numbers for him right now, averaging 17 points a game.
And it seems like we have an invasion of players in the league from Canada.
First personal foul, second team foul. Shooting for the away team.
2019 GA, Alexander Walker, 17th pick in the draft. And he's really close to Shea Gilgeous-Alexander. In fact, they're related. That's his cousin. And they did this really cool jersey swap the first time that they faced off against each other. And SGA actually got the best of them in that game, scored 23 back in 2020. But Canada providing some incredible talent to the league the last few years.
Akers check in for Knox. And there's the pass to Alexander. Off target from outside. Gotten 6 of their 7 shots to go down in this quarter. What a fantastic start to the half. And George kicks to Carter. Passes to George. 4 on the clock. Sinks the triple. George has got 8 points.
It's been this way since halftime. Tremendous production from beyond the arc.
Yeah, pretty infectious right here. Guys in good spirits and percentages from downtown on the rise in the second half.
Giving up a run here, can they turn it around?
It's hard to say right now. At this point, I've seen the coaches run through 2 or 3 iterations of defense. Is there a fourth? I'm not sure.
Here's Quinn. Drains the 19-footer. Quinn's got his second bucket of the night.
Oh, he had him spinning. He looks like he's dizzy after that crossover.
Pass to Carter. Fires for 3. Good for another bucket. He's made half a dozen now. 6 for 8 on the night.
Yeah, that's too good a look to give him from behind the arc.
Alexander passes to Quinn. Overnight. The shot by Quinn, no good.
Shot didn't fall, but that play worked well to get a good look at the basket.
Yeah, an efficient offensive possession. They found the look that they wanted, just didn't go in. Now, those interior passes can be dangerous sometimes, but if the timing is good and you execute it there, you can get easy hoops.
Well, it's been an exciting game. Plenty of offense as we head to the fourth quarter. Up 6. Don't go anywhere, folks. We'll be back in just a moment. And how about a look now at our assist of the game? Brought to you by State Farm.
And he sliced the D wide open with this feed. They had no chance to prevent that basket.
That's what great passing will do for you right there, dissecting the defense with that play.
And it's been a very competitive game so far as we get rolling here in quarter number 4. You've got Maker, Carter out there with Carter, and it's Knight in at the power forward. And it's Carter missing the ball really well in this game, 58%. Here's Quinn, and he's good on the three ball.
confident and composed on the three-point shot at a critical juncture.
Carter outside. Carter outside. The feed to Maker. Goes up on the wing. Goes back up. Basket is good.
D'Angelo.
One more at the line.
Defensive foul.
Nothing too fancy. Just
second personal foul.
When they need
first
to
team
make
foul.
Every possession count.
Shooting for the home team.
And that one misses. Well, they're really making a point of keeping the ball moving around.
That's the key. The D can't focus on one player. And no matter what anybody tells you, that ball will always move quicker than the defender.
Not great numbers, but great effort in this one. It sounds funny, but I think he's
going to
be
good for
that. And you can see him give a little more than just burst to the rim for the alley-oop slam.
A pair of teammates, Greg, with a terrific feel for each other. Now, the backstory of Clint Capela is interesting, as he was only the second player, Greg, from Switzerland to make it to the NBA.
Yeah, Kevin, you know, you don't think of basketball, you think of Switzerland, but the game has grown so much in Europe over the years. Guys like Capela, who might have gone into soccer at one point, are now gravitating towards hoops.
And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Allred.
Hey guys, well, during the break, I was able to catch the message the visiting team coach gave to his team. He said, "We're too concerned with their shooters right now. We've got to close off the inside. They are gutting us." He pleaded with his guys. Come on, let's take a stand. Kevin?
Thanks, David. And the layup's good off the glass.
And of the last six baskets, five have come on the interior. This is just smash-mouth physical basketball, guys.
Here is House. Pass to Carter. For three, that's good again. His seventh basket, 7 for 10 from the floor.
He was sitting back a little bit there in the first half, but feels like showtime now, and he's ready to put some major points up on the board.
Quinn passes to Simon. Three-pointer. It's good for long range.
Answer back there. Love to see the competitiveness.
Yeah, both teams finding ways to the three-point line and trying to take advantage from distance.
Here is House. From 13, he doesn't hit that one.
Yeah, my expectations were that he was not going to miss that one. He handles that kind of defense, especially on the inside.
To the wing right side. Here's Quinn. That shot misses. Some solid defense from Knight. Gone 2 for 5 on field goal attempts in the fourth quarter. Around 3 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter. To the paint. Whoops, they pick off the pass. The pass to Simon. And good that time.
And you just can't draw that up any better. It's a pivotal moment in the game, and they go with the size mismatch for the lane.
And certainly a key for them in this one. 55% from the field. Carter, the best dives. Carter outside. Pocket six. It's blocked. Here's Quinn. Kicks it out to Williamson.
2 minutes remaining in the game. 2 minutes.
And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
Second personal foul. Second team foul.
At the line for your home team. At the line for two.
It's the first, and that makes it a three-point lead. Knox, he's checked in for Maker. And so he drops them both. It's a three-point ball game.
Perfect from the line. It's now a two-possession lead.
T-shirt. Make some
and they're allowing too many points in the paint. Coach is going to let them hear about it.
Yeah, coach knows that. They know that. In the timeout, they're going to hear about it, make the adjustment.
Checking in for your home team. The New Balance player of the game.
And he's just been crushing it from the field tonight, Kevin. Whether it's been on open looks or with the guy draped all over him, he just hadn't missed much. With his percentage in the sky-high range, they'd had no choice but to make him their number one option on every foot.
Second personal foul, first team foul.
Shot clock at six. He stopped the run, and it's wide right. It's off the rim. Down 6-9 on their field goal attempt since the start of the fourth quarter. Stolen. There's 1:26 left in the fourth quarter. He kicks it down. That's tonight. Assist that time. Carter's got 23.
And challenging the bigger defender coming through in the biggest moment.
Yeah, this is a big time moment, and so him stepping up his intensity, staying in attack mode, that's nice.
Knight grabs the board. Gone 3 of 8 here in the fourth quarter. Carter outside. Passes to Fox from 10 feet out. And chain shot.
Remember that one. Guys, a difference maker.
I'm wondering, is that the biggest shot of the game?
It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game.
I mean, he is tearing the defense apart. And let's face it, they have not brought their A game on that side of the ball.
And they go to game time.
First personal foul, third team foul.
Shooting for the home team.
He hits the first one.
Two shots.
That puts it a 3-point lead. So he goes 2 for 2 at the line. It's a 4-point ball game.
Let's see how much fun it is.
Seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Carter right side. Here's House. Can't get it to fall. And they just stop the clock, so there's a foul.
Yeah, second personal foul. The ball. Fourth team foul.
Seconds away.
Shooting for the home team. Taking 2 shots.
Shooting 2.
First free throw is good, and that puts them up by 5. Second one is good. Getting both at the line, and it's a 6-point ball game.
Yeah, that'll ice it right there. Not everybody can keep their composure at the line in such a big situation.
And he commits the intentional foul.
First personal foul, fifth team foul.
At the line for your home team. At the line for 2.
So the first one drops, and that makes it a 7-point lead. And he hits both free throws here. So now it's an 8-point game. Rondo with it. and so they get the victory.